Hi, my name's Ron Keichel. I work for the U.S. Forest Service on the Mount Hood National Forest here in the state of Oregon. And today we're going to talk about one of the most fierce predators in the forest. And before we get started, I want to introduce a friend of mine who's going to help me with this talk. His name's Jack, and he's a great horned owl. He's what's called an education bird. He's lives at the Rowena Wildlife Clinic near Moser, Oregon. Unfortunately, he's had a bad experience with humans. He was hit by a car, so he's blind in one eye. He can no longer go out into the wild and survive. So Jack has been taken care of by Dr. Jean Seifer. She runs the clinic. He's a great horned owl. He's about 14 years old, and I'm going to go through all the different attributes that makes this animal such a great alpha predator. Okay, as we look at Jack here, we can see some really outstanding features. One of the most prominent are these here. Those are called tufts, and they're actually just feathers. The Latin name is plumicorn. Plumo, meaning feather, and corno, meaning horn. And actually what they're used for is, some scientists believe they're used for breaking up his pattern. And we call that camouflage, along with all his other dark feathers. He can hide very well in a tree or any other environment that he's adapted to. As we look at his face, you can see he's got these, what's called facial disc. Okay, and those help him hear. It's like, and he can modify those, and it's like holding your hands to your ears, and it amplifies the sound. So Jack has exceptional hearing. If there was a mouse running through about a foot of snow, Jack would be able to hear through that and grab his prey. Okay. The other wonderful thing about his face is you notice his eyes. His eyes are huge. As a matter of fact, they're about the size of a human being. But being as if they're so large, they're fixed into place, so he can't move them. If we had eyes in comparison, they would be about this big, okay? But I wouldn't be able to move them side to side. So to compensate, Jack's able to turn his head. Good. 270 degrees. And that's very good. We can't do that. But Jack, he has 14 vertebrae in his neck as opposed to our 7. So that helps him compensate for not being able to move his eyes back and forth. His eyes also work great at night, and he can also hunt during the day. He has 3 eyelids, one upper, one lower, and one called the nictitating membrane, which sweeps across his eye to help keep it clean and protect it from debris. All right, so as we move down, you can see he's got a really sharp bill. He's got these, he's covered from head to toe with feathers, and they're really, really soft. And this helps him do one of the greatest things owls do, fly silently. Okay, and the reason they can do that is they have these big broad wings, and they have special comb along the edges. And if you listen carefully, you can hear the difference. This is off of a red-tailed hawk. Now, this is the great horned owl. There's a big difference. And when they swoop down, they don't do a lot of flapping. So it really works well. This he's called a sit and wait predator, so he would be up in his perch, and he had dived quietly down at his prey. Now, as we move down his body, we can see what's called talons. Okay, these talons can be rotated. They're called zygodactyl. So he can bring swivel one around to where he has two up front, two in the back, and a large owl can have like an 8-inch circular spread of his claw. So the middle claw has a super sharp edge, which along with the upper mandible of his beak, he can rip and tear. And the other unique thing about his talons is pressure. I have what's called a dynamometer, and this will tell you how much pressure a human can put out. Pull really hard and get 99 pounds. So, but that's just really, really trying hard. Jack, on the other hand, his talon pressure is anywhere from 200 to 500 pounds, the equivalent of a German Shepherd dog. So when he clamps down, it's really, really serious pressure. Okay, and it takes about 30 pounds to pull that claw off. They're the strongest, with the exception of the Golden Eagle, which can put out 700 pounds of talon pressure. So we discussed Jack's attributes, his extremely good eyesight, his extraordinary hearing, his ability to grab and tear things up, as well as his excellent camouflage and his silent flight. Now you can see Jack's kind of puffing in and out. Well, he's trying to keep cool. It's a little warm in here. So when they're warm or nervous, they have to expel their body heat. And we call that the gular flutter. Okay? So Jack's basically cooling off. Now, great horned owls, this bird has a very wide range of existence, all the way from the subarctic down to South and Central America, which leads us to what they eat. Okay, so Jack, since they can be found in all those areas, the diet's going to be diverse. They've recorded over 250 different species of animals that owls will eat. Jack and even larger birds than him, larger great horned owls, can eat things like, their specialty is mice, voles, rats, small rodents, rabbits. But they can also eat, take down porcupines, great blue herons, Canada geese. They'll walk into water to grab crayfish, they'll eat snakes, lizards, and on, even been known to take out armadillos. They also like skunks. Okay, you're saying, wow, skunks. That's one thing Jack doesn't have, is a sense of smell, or a very good one at that, so he can take down skunks. They have a very, very diverse diet, but they like to swallow their food whole if they can. If they can't, like I said, they're going to tear it into pieces. And they can actually store their food. And in the wintertime, if their food stores are frozen, they'll actually sit on it to incubate it. Okay, not a good idea for you as a youngster to go home and try to sit on any frozen food that's in the fridge. Parents won't appreciate that very much. If they swallow mice and rats, they can't really digest the bones, the fur, or feathers of birds that they eat. So what they'll do after about 10 hours is cough up a pellet, which is about 2 inches in length. And scientists like to go through those and pick out the bones and see what the owl has actually been eating, to see if it's got a varied diet or just one of certain animals. Jack here, he's about 14 years old. In the wild, owls generally live 10 to 12 years. But in captivity, they've been known to live up to 28 years, which is a long time. But in captivity, they don't have to compete with anything for food, and they're well taken care of. Jack has his own flight area to go to. So he does rather well. And he'll probably be around for a long time. Jack is a male great horned owl. If a female was sitting next to him, she would be about this tall. They can have a wingspan up to 5 feet. Along with the large wide wingspan, they can also carry their own weight in food. So if you have a 2-pound owl, they can actually carry off something that's about 2 pounds in weight. It's called wing loading, and they've got the highest wing loading of any raptor in the United States. Owl's breeding season is going to be January and February, and the pair will lay 2 to 4 eggs about this size, with 2 to 3 being the norm, 6 being a lot. It depends on food supply, basically. They're going to nest, but they do not build their own nest. They move into other nests, like of hawks and things like that. So they're not great nest builders. The female is the one that's going to sit on the eggs. Both male and female provide food for their young. The eggs will hatch after about 6 weeks. The young will start to fly 9 to 10 weeks after birth. So, and then they will span out on their own to find territories. Okay, great horned owls in the wild are essential predators. They help keep other animals in check. So that makes them very important to keep the balance in the wild. The male and female will defend their nest really, really well. So if you come across a nesting pair, please stay the distance from them. Try not to disturb them. So we've talked about all of Jack's attributes and what makes him such a remarkable predator. So when you're out in the woods enjoying the public lands, please keep in mind it's a home for all these wonderful creatures like Jack and many others. On behalf of the Rowena Wildlife Clinic and the U.S. Forest Service, we'd like you to tread lightly and leave no trace. And thank you for watching.